What's up, guys? This is Suspicious Squid, and today I want to make a video about Valorant. More specifically, I want to make an introduction or a guide for people who aren't super familiar with the competitive FPS genre like myself. So consider this a noob's guide to Valorant. So first, let me give you a little bit of background into my history with the genre. As far as competitive games go, the only games I have real experience playing competitively are Overwatch and Gears of War. That's pretty much it. I've been playing Counter-Strike since a young age. However, I more so played just, you know, custom lobbies, zombie escape, or survival maps and stuff like that. I should also add that I've always found the mechanics, at least in a competitive environment, in games like Counter-Strike, very hard to wrap my head around, and very difficult to get into, especially since there's been already such a large established competitive community where I don't necessarily feel comfortable competing or playing because I just kind of get shit on the entire time. But with that being said, since Valorant's a new game, I do find myself a little more intrigued and a little more eager and willing to learn the mechanics of the game. Outside of that, there are other elements present that make it a little more forgiving, I would say, based on my experience. But I've overall been having a lot more fun with it than I've had with Counter-Strike. So what is Valorant? Valorant, at its core design, is a first-person shooter with MOBA elements. I say MOBA more than hero shooter because of the fact that Riot actually had a big part in helming a lot of the features that define the hero shooter genre. So I just wanted to bring that back. Teams are comprised of 5 people, each of which selects an agent that has a specific set of abilities. It's best of 25 rounds, so 1st to 13. And then from there, your objective is either to plant the bomb at one of the sites or eliminate the enemy team. There's also a currency system in place at the beginning of every round, where you can buy weapons, armor, or abilities. You can even buy weapons for your teammates, but that's limited to specifically weapons. You can't buy them any armor or abilities. Once you get into the game, everything seems simple enough, but there's a few things you'll notice once you begin to play. For starters, your crosshair is a liar. Well, not exactly, but unlike something like Call of Duty or Battlefield, it acts more as a guide rather than telling you precisely where your bullets are going to go. Also, in order to have any accuracy, you absolutely cannot be moving and shooting. This game rewards pinpoint accuracy and intelligent positioning. Don't go in expecting to be Rambo or playing this like Call of Duty. If you do, you'll have a bad time. Once I realized this, I went from the bottom of the leaderboard my first few games to being either in 1st or 2nd once I wrapped my head around the mechanics. The first shot of each gun is also pinpoint accurate, with the latter 4 to 6 also being very accurate, so make those first shots count. Anything after that becomes much more difficult to control unless you have a strong grasp on the recoil patterns of each weapon, which I'm still very much in the process of learning. But you could always go into the practice range to work on a particular weapon if you're having any issues in game. I initially started using the Phantom, which is the rifle given to you in the tutorial, and I was mildly successful with it, not really doing anything too crazy. It's a good gun, don't get me wrong, but think of this as the M4 from CSGO. I found much more success once I started using the Guardian, which is a semi-automatic rifle as it has a higher damage output and better range. In general right now, I see most players using either rifles or SMGs, but I've seen some people do some serious damage with the sniper rifles too, but I'm not quite comfortable enough with those yet to really rack up the kills. But this brings me to my next point. I was originally using weapons other people told me to use, none of which recommended the Guardian to me. So my recommendation if you're a new player is to just experiment with the weapons that you feel most comfortable with, as this game rewards gun skill above anything else. This combined with solid communication from your team and map knowledge from repeated games, with best practices like holding angles and playing smartly, is a surefire way to succeed above anything else. Don't let other players overcomplicate it for you. I also briefly want to talk about some of the agents and their abilities. I'm still learning the game, so I'll tell you about the 2 agents that I personally have been having an easier time with and why. For starters is Sova, who functions as a scout. He's good at moving forward before the action starts and getting crucial intel on the enemy team's position and strat. I think he's a good start because even if you're not necessarily great when you start playing, you can be of huge use to your team by getting them a read on enemy positions. His C ability is the Owl Drone, a flying drone that you can take direct control of that can also fire darts to reveal enemy positions to your team. Anyone hit with the dart has to hold F to remove it. You can also use this to see if a lane is clear or if there is a cheeky sniper hiding somewhere in the distance, so you don't go and get yourself shot. Next, we have his E, the Recon Bolt, which is an arrow that reveals enemy positions through walls within a certain area. You can bounce the arrow up to 2 times if you need to get it into a trickier spot. This ability is arguably his most important, as it can help your team tremendously during a push. His Q is the Shock Arrow, which works in basically the same way as a Recon Arrow, except it has an AoE electric shock that is good at spooking enemies around corners or killing players with low HP. Finally, we have his ultimate, or X, Hunter's Fury, which are huge global arrows that can shoot straight through walls for massive damage. This, when used in combination with recon bolts and good positioning, deal crazy damage and can easily get you 1 or 2 kills when used correctly. Just be aware that enemies see an outline of your shots before you fire. The next agent I like to use is Omen. He functions as a flanker and has abilities that can both help you score kills and assist your teammates. At least in my experience starting, when you're not so good at winning straight confrontations, using Omen can help you get into more advantageous positions that can set you up for easier kills while also simultaneously using his abilities for recon, like Soma, which is a great benefit to your team as a whole. For starters, we have his E, Dark Cover, which is essentially a smoke grenade that can either be used to make a sightline easier for you or your teammates to cross, or as a distraction to give you cover to either move to another position or fool the enemy team into thinking you're going one way when you're not. His C is Shrouded Step, which is a teleport that can quickly get you across sightlines into safe cover or into a position where you can spot enemies. His Q is Paranoia, which is a projectile that goes through walls that obscures the sight of enemies. This is great for prepping a push or for simply spooking an enemy. Finally, we have his ult, From the Shadows, which instantly lets Omen teleport to any area on the map. You have to be careful though, because the position you're teleporting to will have your silhouette, and enemies can shoot it to cancel your teleport. During the time it takes you to teleport, it will obscure the enemy map also, which makes them aware that you're using your ult, so bear that in mind. A strat I like to use often on attack is to have my teammates fake push an objective to draw the enemy's attention there. During the chaos, I'll teleport to the opposite bombsite and plant, wasting the enemy's time and giving us the advantage to safely rotate back to that site. He's probably my personal favorite at the moment. I'd also recommend Sage, simply because her ability to heal and revive is a huge advantage to any team. However, I'd recommend learning her after getting familiar with the mechanics and maps, so that you can put her to good use and not get flamed by your teammates for wasting her crucial abilities. I also briefly want to talk about the agent abilities in simple terms, because at a glance they can seem very complicated. So I'm going to break it down very simply. They essentially fall into 2 categories, lethal and non-lethal. In essence, they replace the grenades in Counter-Strike. Think of them like that. Obviously, there's a lot more nuance in terms of how you can use one agent's abilities, especially in combination with another. But I feel like this explanation makes it a lot less overwhelming, and there's plenty of in-depth pro guides out there that go into the specifics of each agent's abilities. With all of that being said, I'm going to give you guys a few small tips that help me tremendously as a new player. The first is communicate. I can't stress how important it is to coordinate with your team. This will make the difference between winning rounds and losing them. Besides the obvious benefits like coordinating more advanced strategies, it's simply a good way for you to learn the game. Don't be afraid to ask for advice or about a specific weapon or ability. You'll encounter the occasional bad egg, but in general, people are more than willing to help you learn the game, and you'll get more comfortable with common callouts and map locations while you're at it. Soon enough, you'll know all of the lingo. Another helpful tip is to customize your crosshair. I made mine static by shutting off aim error and other associated features. Results may vary, but I have found it a lot less stressful to learn the recoil patterns of the weapons when my crosshair isn't going nuts. On top of that, it's also very visually distracting for me. But even if that's not your thing, there's plenty of options for you to help set yourself up for success. So go experiment. Always play angles. Always. And check your corners every time before moving forward. The amount of times I've died simply because I didn't check an angle or a corner when I started is ridiculous. And when you combine playing angles with keeping your crosshair at about neck to head level, suddenly scoring kills becomes so much easier, and you'll see the benefit almost immediately. Another thing I also see a lot of new players doing is pushing forward way more than they need to when they're on defense. You're on defense. There's no need. You have time on your side and the ability to set up defensive positions to get the drop on the attackers. Use those to your advantage and don't get greedy. Lastly, focus on using burst fire rather than spraying. You won't regret it. The recoil is a lot for a new player to handle when spraying, so only use it in the proper circumstances. If you remember to use all these tips, you'll see the quality of your gameplay improve dramatically. I learned these from experience, and when you really start to get a handle on everything, this game can be one of the most rewarding shooters out there. So remember, don't be overwhelmed, Everything in this game can be learned, trained, and mastered. And I hope that if you're new to this game and watching this, that you can take what I've said and apply it. So best of luck. I had to move the camera because the lighting got messed up. But if you enjoyed the video and you found anything I said helpful, or you want to see more Valorant content or have some ideas or thoughts, just drop them in the comments. I appreciate you guys watching, and I'm excited to make more videos. So this is Suspicious Squid signing out.